So right now in my world, it is Mother's Day weekend. And last minute, I decided why not make a charcuterie bouquet. So that's what I'm gonna do today. Trying to make an edible version of this thing here. I already went to H-E-B and got all the food that I needed. So fingers crossed that this comes out looking great for my grandmother that my mom wanted to give her for Mother's Day. That's in 2 days. So let's get chopping, cutting, folding, and everything else involved around charcuterie. Yes, you sound like my sister. What's their father? Their father, their daddy? As you saw, we just did our roses, and now we're gonna take our long wooden skewers and we're just gonna poke them right through, just like this. My goal is to kind of aim for the pieces that tend to flare up really quickly, because I really want to keep the shape. So just like that. All right, super easy. As this is an impromptu charcuterie board slash video with you guys, I am slightly winging it, but low key, I feel like my best work sometimes is when I'm winging it, but I do know what I'm talking about and doing, so that's a plus. So now, for shame, now we're gonna move on to our provolone cheese. So next, I'm gonna take some provolone cheese. I'm gonna double it. We're gonna experiment and see if this works. So we're gonna take one of our sticks. So here I had a great idea to use these skewer sticks and put hearts on the skewer sticks that were cheese. Okay, I don't know if that actually worked. However, as I'm fast forwarding this, it did not work out. My plans did not work out. A lot of charcuterie is just trial and error and doing things that are appeasing to your eye or your client's eye, or just wanting to be inventive. So instead, I just took my heart cookie cutter and I just cookie cuttered the provolone cheese. Also, great fun fact that I just found out right now, fresh provolone cheese tastes amazing. I have never been a fan of provolone cheese, like period. It always tasted really tangy to me and didn't have much flavor, but usually the cheese that I was tasting came already pre-packaged and truly pre-cut. But when I went to H-E-B, they have like a pre-cut section, but it's freshly cut. And so that's the provolone cheese that I got. And I'm sitting over here like tasting it again. This is my grandmother, so I don't feel too bad. But y'all, it tastes so good. There's so much flavor. It almost kind of reminds me of Gouda in a way, but a lot lighter, but so much better than getting it that was packaged who knows how long ago from the cheese section of the grocery store. So yeah, I usually get all my cheeses fresh, but provolone, I've never done fresh. I was missing out because it's good. Speaking of fresh cut cheeses, let's get into these bad boys right here. So we have our horseradish, buffalo hot sauce, and our smoked Gouda with bacon, and then our steakhouse onion cheeses. These all are H-E-B specials. They are already pre-cut and fresh by H-E-B. And so I'm going to honestly just take these and put them on the skewer. Now, due to my glasses having a lovely glare, we're just gonna take these bad boys off and just kind of hope for the best, okay? Because I do want to get contacts one of these days. I was afraid to get contacts for a while, but now that I am a grown up, it's time to make big girl decisions and get contacts. Because I don't think I'm ready to do LASIK. I don't know, that frightens me. Anyways, now that you can see my eyes better, we are going to, I was gonna say thread, but we're gonna put blueberries onto our skewers. I feel like I'm just gonna say sticks because honestly, saying skewers, I feel like I just might say it wrong. But I'm kind of putting them like this. They kind of look like little beads. That's kind of the goal slash my purpose. So I'm gonna do three on one. And then on this next one, I might do five. Something about doing odd numbers when you are decorating or displaying certain things, it makes the eye make it look more full. Strawberries, blueberries, grapes. So my goal is to kind of emulate what this is right here. So let's see if I can do that. Now, we're still working through the color scheme, the arrangement, because right now I am not feeling confident in what we've done so far. And it's probably because of the orange cheese. It's throwing me off a little bit, but it's one of her favorite cheeses. So we keep it. Pressing forward. She also really likes these powdered donut holes. So I figured, why not put our odd number of three on these bad boys? And then we're gonna top it off with one of these Rocher golden tickets, which I used to enjoy these. Ooh, that worked just well. Okay, I'm gonna kind of pull that up a little bit. I used to enjoy these a lot in my mid 20s. And then I realized why I always thought they had like a strange aftertaste. I thought it was just
you know, the chocolate, the hazelnut, maybe combination, because I didn't really eat it anywhere else. But I found out, when your tongue goes numb on something, 9 times out of 10, you're allergic. You should probably not eat it. So that's how I found out I was allergic to these guys.
Okay, so this is what we have so far. I mean, it's slowly working. Maybe I can see potential. It's giving a fall flower board more than spring, which is kind of what I wanted, but it's a garlic and herb version. So we're just gonna place these on the side. Actually, I'm gonna place it together. So I'm just gonna do two. Oh my God. So these are lemon cookies. I know my grandmother enjoys lemons, so we will place 3 here for now. Still not a huge fan of our looks. All right, so we are going to add some greenery. Here's what we're looking like. Still working it out. I have some rosemary, I have some basil, and then I'm gonna add some baby's breath. Now my baby's breath, along with the roses, have been rinsed, sprayed with fruit and veggie soap. She's not going to eat them. We'll use them around the food, but we are good. So let's just kind of add some greenery amongst. For the crackers, I'm gonna give her a couple crackers, and I figured why not put them in a cupcake plastic tin. I ended up getting sea salt black and pepper crackers along with rosemary crackers. Quiet on set, Faith, I'm recording. My little sister got home from her job. She works at a bridal shop. Is it a bridal shop or a bridal boutique?
Bridal shop.
Bridal shop. So I'm gonna put the crackers like this. So this is one kind of crackers. And then, do you wanna come say hi? She looks super cute today. Oh man, I thought there was something on your nose, but it's just your glasses.
Oh.
This is my sissy face. Oh, did you get makeup on my shirt?
No.
Okay. Okay. And then we have the salt and pepper crackers. And I'm gonna lay them at the foot of this. Did you just steal something? I feel like you stole something. So I put these crackers just at the base. And then we have the top. So we have, I actually like the way this came out, you guys.
Spend more money than what she originally spent.
Well, that's good. She didn't waste your time then. She spent more money.
No. She hasn't done it yet. But I'm saying, all like we try all these different dress on stuff. Just to go with the same dress that she already bought because she was complaining that was too much money. She was trying to find something else. Just
can I show mom what I made? Mom, I want to see your reaction.
Oh my gosh!
Yeah,
well,
yeah, I'm gonna look.
Oh my god!
So I mean,
I'm not looking.
You can look now.
Okay.
Oh my god!
Wait. There we go.
Oh my goodness! That is so beautiful.
Is it really? You have to be honest. No, no, no. You're my mom.
I'm serious. seriously, I'm being very serious.
What should I get from this angle, even though it's a really weird angle?
I know. It's, oh my goodness, it really is beautiful.
I need the glasses. I need the glasses so I could see good. But you like it?
It's beautiful, honey. Yay. Aww.
Okay, so I am pretty excited about how this board came out. You saw from the beginning / different parts how we were honestly a little scared with all the colors, the different textures, and the fact that it's all just clumped in one section. Now, I do know that, of course, with the charcuterie board, all your food is centered in one plate. Like, the goal of a charcuterie board is to not see the board. So I get that, but this was just different and new to me, so. The sun has gone down. My mom is watching TV with her salad. My sister is now home from work, and silence is no longer an option in my life. So I'm gonna clean up this mess. But if you enjoyed this video, remember to hit the subscribe button, go ahead and like, and then check out the next video, like this one right there.